You know, one of our main focuses here at CREW is studying the reproduction of endangered cat species. And to do that, we work with domestic cats primarily to understand basic reproduction. One of the main issues that we have here in the United States is overpopulation of dogs and cats. And it's estimated that we have about 80 million free-roaming cats just in the U.S. So a single domestic cat that's breeding could have 50 to 100 kittens in her lifetime. So there's a lot of interest in controlling overpopulation of domestic cats. And the primary way that we do that now is through trap, neuter, return programs. So what we've been working on is trying to develop a non-surgical way to spay domestic cats or neuter domestic cats. And the primary focus that we have is using a form of gene therapy.
And what this hormone does is it works very locally on the ovary. So the cat's ovary will produce this every month when she cycles. But if there was a way that we could actually produce this hormone on a much larger level, then the entire ovary would be suppressed all the time. And so that's what we did with gene therapy.
The main advantage of this particular approach, if we can get gene therapy to work effectively, is it eliminates the need to have a veterinarian do a surgical procedure on the animal.
We had 9 cats in this study, so relatively small. 3 of them were control cats that we didn't treat, and so they were just there to make sure everything was normal, if you will. We had 6 cats we did treat with this vector, and so we followed these cats out for 2 years. And during that time, we did various endpoints. We did 2 breeding trials. So for 4 months, these cats were housed with a male 8 hours a day, 5 days a week. And what we saw is that all 3 control females became pregnant and had normal litters. None of the treated cats in either trial ever became pregnant. So one of my most favorite aspects of this study is that we have concluded our portion here at CREW, and now these cats get to retire. These cat scientists are retiring and getting to go be adopted and go live in their forever homes.
If we can expand the use of this approach beyond a veterinary practice and have just regular people out there trapping and injecting these cats, then I think that's doable.
These cats receive physical exams regularly, starting 2 weeks before their treatment, at the time of treatment, and we saw no off-target effects at all, which, you know, again, is a really important aspect of this study. So if we can find an alternative to having to use surgery to spay them, if we can simply do that non-surgically, in essence, a form of long-term contraception, that has the ability to actually make a significant impact on these populations long-term.